Good morning, everyone. This is your good old neighbor, Nicky and Frozen 2, and nope, time to die, fan 2001, yo. And welcome to the next amazing video, and yes, people, I know I'm up early in the morning, so I just want to get my day started. I just got my clothes on, got my feet on, which is pretty crazy at 4 in the morning, anyway. Anyway, guys, so today I'm doing my top 5 weakest Pixar movie of all time. I have a top 5 instead of my top 10. Well, I just need to remove Cars out of my best Pixar movie ever made, but I don't know. You know what? Let's continue the video. So, guys, these are the Pixar movie I kind of got bored, and it's really weakest, and the number one will be the worst Pixar movie I have ever seen. It would be no Dishonored to mention, so there's no crappy Pixar movie, so it's gonna be the weakest. So welcome back to another top 10, and so today I'm doing my top 5 weakest Pixar movie of all time. Enough talking, let's get started, shall we? If you guys like this movie, good for you. But for me, this movie is easily one of the most overrated movie of 2015. Alright, guys, coming in number 5 is Inside Out. This movie was really guilty pleasure, but honestly, it's overrated at the same time. But I just don't understand why some people treasure it. I don't understand why people call it one of the best animated movie of 2015. I do think Sponge Out of the Water is easily one of my favorite anime movie of 2015. At least this movie looks much better than Strange Magic. Yeah, I have that movie. And honestly, guys, I hate to say it, but Joy is easily one of the worst Pixar character that I ever created. I don't understand why Pete Docter was thanky for making this movie, man. Like, come on, Pete Docter, he was a really awesome director because he directed Monster Inc., Up, and Soul, which is my favorite Pixar movie ever. But this just has to be one of his weakest film he ever directed. And honestly, I do think Pete Docter is easily one of the best director from Pixar, but he could do better than that. But honestly, I just have to feel positive about the movie. Like, so yeah, and his some animation looks pretty decent to look at. And I do admit. I think the ending was really emotional. I just really crying that scene anyway. And that Bing Bong character, oh boy, I don't understand why some people like Bing Bong character, but I do think he's a really annoying character. But honestly, at least he's not annoying than Joy. Honestly, I cannot stand Joy. And her voice acting, which honestly, Edmund Poland, this just has to be one of your worst performance you ever did. It's kind of shame I say that. It's because it's a Pixar movie, so yeah. And sorry, guys, and some characters in the movie, like fear, anger, sadness, and disgust, honestly, the whole character is really alright. It's not an alright character. And I do admit, I think disgust is really cute, but honestly. And sorry, guys, and that's why Inside Out is in my number 5. Let's get to the number 2, let's get to the number 4 spot. Well, even this movie is a 7 out of 10, but overall, I think this movie is not good. It's not because the movie how dark it is. It's because this movie has a tomato as a main character, which is honestly one of the most stupidest ideas I have ever heard from Pixar. Alright, guys, coming to number 4 is Cars 2. I don't understand why some people are taking this movie way too seriously and call it one of the worst Pixar movie ever. Have you not seen The Good Dinosaur? I think The Good Dinosaur is even worse than that movie. Oopsie, I spoiled that. Never mind. I'll probably you guys already know what my worst Pixar is, you know? And sorry, guys, just has a few pauses about the movie. I really like the action of the movie. And I do admit, I think the story of the spy story, I have no problem with them making the spy story. It's kind of remind me you're watching a James Bond but with cars in it. And honestly, I do think Finn Missile is easily one of the best characters in the movie. But honestly, this just has to be one of his weakest performances by Michael Shannon. But honestly, I think Michael Shannon is really a legend. But him as Finn Missile is gonna be one of his weakest performances he ever did. So Michael Shannon from the Christopher Nolan movie is way better than him as Finn Missile. And Holly Shipwell is honestly, she's really cute as a car anyway. any animation looks pretty to look at, like especially, well, come on, we can't trash Pixar animation because we never trash Pixar animation anyway. Anyway, guys, and I still have a few negative about the movie, like Professor Z, honestly, one of the worst Pixar villain I have ever seen in my life, because Professor X is so awful, it's so stupid, and it's got to be one of the worst villain of 2011. And I do think, honestly, making Mato as a main character, this just had to be one of the stupidest ideas I have ever heard from Pixar, honestly. And the biggest thing I have this movie huge negative, and then make everyone hate this movie, it has to be the rating, just like The Hunchback of Notre Dame. Why this movie is a rated G movie? Like, come on, this movie have violence, this movie have gun, this movie have an explosion, this movie have a death scene, and you give this movie a G rating? What the heck is wrong with you rating first Hunchback of Notre Dame, now this? Oh, let's try again. Okay, rating, I'm stuffy right here. Okay, first you give The Hunchback of Notre Dame rated G, which honestly is stupid, but you give Cars 2 like a rated G film. Thank God right here it's rated PG. I was going to be almost angry that right here is rated G, which is stupid. And it's the main reason why I do not like rated G anymore. I don't understand why I used to like it, but now I think rated G is the worst rating I ever seen. At least it's way better than NC-17. Which honestly, if I watch NC-17 film, I might get my butt in jail. Like I say like a million times. If you don't believe me, just look at a stupid wall, because people keep making stupid wall for the site you come from. And sorry guys, and that's why Cars 2 is then my number 4. Let's get to number 3. Honestly guys, I used to love this movie, but now, every time I think on a movie, and a lot of time it's a really okay Pixar movie. I need to remove this movie out of my Pixar best Pixar movie ever, but I don't want to do that, so I'm just going to keep it. Alright guys, coming to number 3, it had to be Cars 1. Honestly, I think this movie is a really guilty pleasure 2006 movie. But honestly, I do think I am not a huge fan of a Cars franchise, which honestly, I don't understand why I was a huge fan of Cars at the beginning, but I was a Cars fanboy, I got all the Cars merchandise, and thank God I just gave away my Cars merchandise, I don't need all that. Well, the only Cars merchandise I have gotten, it's had to be the one Mato and Lightning McQueen. And honestly, guys, my favorite character of this movie, it's had to be Lightning McQueen. Honestly, Lightning McQueen is easily one of the second best performance for Albert Wilson. But honestly, best Albert Wilson performance, it has to be him as him from that Wookiee show. And so, hey guys, and Doc Hudson, honestly, rest in peace to that. Rest in peace to Paul Newman. Rest in peace to him, man. He was dying due to the crash, so rest in peace, so... So yeah, and this has to be one of his last film he ever voiced, so yeah. Any animation looks pretty to look at, I really like the animation of the film. Any motion scene of every single character is really emotional. And honestly, the worst character in this movie, it had to be Chick Hicks. Honestly, where'd you get that last name from? For me, yeah, I'm probably Chick Hicks, still my last name, so yeah. Sorry guys, I do think Mato is really this would have been annoying, but Lightning McQueen Mato has some really best friend chemistry from every single characters. And sorry guys, and that's why Cars is number 3. Let's get to number 2. So yesterday it was the anniversary of this movie, right? But honestly, I do think this movie is one of the most overrated movies of 2017. Well, they took any problem with Cars 2 and make Cars 3 as a white-hearted movie, which honestly I didn't mean to do that. Honestly guys, it's not one YouTuber really think this movie is one of the best movies ever made, which is not. It's had to be Megan Carlson, honestly. I'm sorry, I just didn't enjoy this movie at all. Alright guys, coming to number 2, this has to be Cars 3. Honestly, I think Cars 3 is easily one of the most overrated movies of 2017. I'm gonna watch way better than a movie. At least this movie is a way better summer movie than the Emoji Movie. F that movie. Sorry guys, and I do think the animation is pretty to look at. And I think Cruz is a really cute character of the movie. I know she's really annoying, but I do think she's a really cute character in the movie. And Storm is honestly one of the weakest Cars villain I've ever seen. At least he's way better than Professor Z, anyway. They took the spy story and now they make it as a wasting movie, which I didn't mean to do that, anyway. Anyway, guys, in the racy scene of this movie, it's kind of boring to watch anyway. I did not enjoy this movie when I saw this movie in theaters, and I kind of agree with my buddy Chris. Even my buddy Chris didn't enjoy this movie. And guess what? You fail, Pixar. You fail. And this is honestly one of the most okay conclusion from the Cars movie. I don't want to hear them making Cars 4. I don't want to hear that. It's stupid. So, hey, guys, and that's why Cars 3 is my number 2. Well, let's get to number 1, because it's not the weakest. It's the worst. It's the worst. No other Pixar movie will be as bad as my number 1. So my number 1 weakest / worst Pixar movie I have ever seen has to be The Good Dinosaur. What is this movie? I cannot believe I saw this movie in videos. You know what? Put a picture of Brooklyn to you guys, say it's a bad movie. Yeah. Yeah, this is my reaction. I saw The Good Dinosaur. There is no need you make a 2-pixel movie one day. I don't understand why this movie is even made. I don't understand why this movie is even made. I do agree with Broken T-Guy. Even SML did not like this movie. I agree. But this movie is completely awful. The story. Honestly. What else I have to say about the story? The story is a completely rip-off to The Lion King. If you watch The Lion King, Pixar, you know what? Even a word Pixar, because this movie in a nutshell. They took the element from The Lion King, from Mufasa's death scene. You swivel it away, and now you get your own father and son movies. Honestly, let me see from that movie from the director. Let me see. It's for it's from a director who made it's from the director who made Patty Crowd, which honestly, I really love that. Oops, sorry about that, guys. I just pushed the wrong button with my thumb. Anyway, guys, honestly, this has to be one of his worst movie he ever directed. So let's see his upcoming movie would be much better. And honestly, guys, I do agree with the water people. Even this movie flopped the box office. This movie was so bad. And honestly, this movie was so bad that this movie bombed the box office. Which honestly, it definitely deserved it, because this movie did not need to be made in the first place. Sorry about the guys, I'm just completely sneezing, I'm just completely crapple. And the villain of this movie. For a Pixar movie. But this just had to be one of the lamest Pixar villain I have ever seen in my life. And the auto, this just had to be one of the worst characters of the movie, because all he do is screaming and crying and running away like a skatey cat and Shaggy, but honestly, I do agree with Brooklyn T Guy. This is the main reason why I hate The Good Dinosaur, The Flaming But Impassion, and I should put this movie as my worst movie of 2015. But honestly, this is honestly one of the worst November movie of 2015. This is easily one of the worst dinosaur movies I have ever seen in my life, next to Jurassic Park 3. And I gotta say, but The Good Dinosaur, more like the bad movie, is my number one weakest / worst Pixar movie I have ever seen in my life. And I swear to God, if I rewatch this movie again, I'm just going to turn the TV off and rewatch Frozen 2. That is a way better than watching Good Dinosaur. Hey guys, if you want to watch a way better Pixar movie, just go see Lightyear. Just go watch Turning Red. Just go watch Luca. Just go watch Soul. Just go watch Onward. Just go watch A Bug's Life. Just go watch Toy Story. Go watch all these classic Pixar movies. It's way better. It's worth your time than the bad movies. So I took the movie to Thursday, but I just cannot stand The Good Dinosaur. More like the bad movie, because it's a bad movie. So hey guys, that was my top 5 weakest Pixar movie I have ever seen in my life. I might do my top 5 underrated Pixar movie when I go see Lightyear, because I don't understand why Lightyear is getting bad review from critic, from audience, and I don't understand why Lightyear is getting I don't understand why Lightyear is going to be the most controversial movie of 2022. Honestly, it's going to be Joker all over again. It's going to be The Last Jedi over again, so I really hope I don't hate Lightyear. Really hope not. So I was really wish that movie would be even better than Toy Story 4. Honestly, guys, even I love Toy Story 4, but honestly, I do think Toy Story 4 is, I don't know, one of the weakest Toy Story movies I've ever seen. And sorry guys, if you liked this video, hit the subscribe button, notification, show it's family. And so, this is the only video you're going to get, because I just don't feel like making two videos in one day. So, stay tuned for my other video in the future. I might do a committee tab, what's the next video you want me to do, so yeah. And sorry guys, if you want me to redo my Finding Dory review today, nah, I don't want to do that, so, and tomorrow, stay tuned for my redo review on Ruka. Honestly, that older review on Ruka, it didn't age well because I hate the villain of the movie, so yeah. And honestly, I used to hate him, but now I like him, just because of Freeman, so yeah. So hey guys, subscribe, comment, share with his family. I'm done for today. I'm just gonna cry down because my mom and Chris is asleep. We gotta be respectful. Not disrespectful. Sorry guys, I'll see you next time. So long, peace YouTube.
Maybe I don't want to watch The Good Dinosaur, Karen. You ever think about that?
But it's such a good movie, Boydie!
No, it's not a good movie. It shouldn't be called The Good Dinosaur. It should be called The Bad Movie, because it's a bad movie.